My dear children, how are you? This is your HM ma'am with you in a mathematics class. We want to study your chapter number 6. The name of the chapter is Squares and Square Roots. Before going to the content, we must know what are square numbers. Square numbers. If we multiply a number, a natural number, by itself, then we get a square number. See, the first natural number we have, this is 1. No? If we multiply 1 by itself, then we get 1. So, multiplying this first natural number, this is the first natural number, by itself we get the first square number. Now the second natural number is 2. Multiplying 2 by itself we get the next square number, 4. Similarly, multiplying 3 by itself we get 9. This is the third square number. In this way we will be getting, this is after that 16, then 25, then 36, then 49, then so on. Okay, if we multiply a natural number by itself, then we get a square number. In your book, in the page number 90, there is a table. There is a table showing the squares of natural numbers. This is 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, and up to 20 square. It is given here. You have to cram this whole table. Otherwise, you will not be able to do anything. Okay? Now, how you can find the square numbers? In the set of natural numbers, all the numbers are not square numbers. There are some square numbers in the set of natural numbers. We have to find out that numbers. There are so many ways to find these square numbers. The easiest one is this one. By multiplying a number by itself, we get the square numbers. There are other systems also. Today, we will discuss about the other two numbers. Other two systems. Okay. My dear children, now you want to know the second technique of finding the square numbers. This is from what? This is from the set of odd numbers. You know, these are the odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 14, 15. These are all odd numbers. From these odd numbers, we can find the square numbers. How? We know, this is the first natural number. This is also an odd number. This first natural number is also a first square number. Okay? Now we add these two consecutive odd numbers. 1 plus 3. This is first. Then this is second. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. This is the second square number. If we add the three consecutive odd numbers, 1 plus 3 plus 5, then we get 9. This is the third square number. Now, in this way, if we add 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, then we get 16. This is the next square number, 5. This is the next square number. If we add up 9, it is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. We get 25. In this way, next 36, then 49, and so on. So, from the set of odd numbers we can also find the this square number. But this is a very lengthy process. Okay, the easiest one is that this multiplying a number by itself. Multiplying a number by itself. In the third technique, from triangular numbers we can get the square numbers. Then first of all we must know what is this triangular number. A number in the form of triangle is called triangular number. If this is the first triangular number, then the second triangular number will be like this. Third triangular number will be like this. 3, 2, 1. Then 4, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then the next one will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. These are called triangular numbers. And if you write here the number of balls here, here is one ball, here is three ball, here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ball, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. These are the triangular numbers. Then from these triangular numbers, we can also find the square numbers. How? This is the first square number we know. First natural number is the first square number. This is the first square number. And if we add this one, then we get the second square number. If we add these two, then we get the, this is the first, second, third, then this is fourth, then this is fifth, then this is sixth. In this way, this can be extended. So this is the first square number, this is second, this is third, this is fourth, this is fifth, and this is the sixth square number. In this way, we will be getting all the square numbers. My dear children, now we want to know some of the properties of the square numbers. Some of the properties of square numbers. Can you see the board? Yes. Now the first property, in the first property we have, a square number must have the digit 0, 1, 4, 5, 9, etc. in its unit place. If it is a square number, then it must have this 0 or 1 or 4 or 5 or 6 or 9 in its unit place. Say this is a number 36. This is a square number, unit place is 6. This is a square number 25, the unit place is 5. And this is property number 2. A square number must have two zeros in the right side with a square number on the left. It must have two zeros in the right side with a square number on the left. This is a square number. Because these are two zeros, this is a square number. This is 900, this is also a square number. Then 1600, then 3600, these are all square number, because so on the right side there are two zeros and on the left side this is a square number. These are the two properties of square number. Okay. Suppose you are given with a group of numbers and you have to find out the square numbers among these numbers, but you can't find square number in this way. Only you can eliminate that which numbers are not square numbers. First of all, you see if 1 is there, it may be 1 is there in the unit place, it may be a square number. If 2 is there in the unit place, then it cannot be a square number. You can eliminate this one. If 3 is in the unit place, this cannot be a square number. But if 5 is in the unit place, it may be a square number. If 6 is on the unit place, then it may be a square number. But it cannot be a square number. It cannot be a square number. But it can be a square number. It can be a square number. It can be a square number. It cannot be a square number. It cannot be a square number. It can be a square number. It can be a square number. It cannot be a square number. It cannot be. Yes, it can be. It can be. Okay. So, we can't, this is not very easy to find this square number from a group of numbers. Only we can eliminate the numbers. And if we find, if we want to know whether this number is a square number or not, we have to use the technique of this prime factorization. In the way of prime factorization, we can find whether this number is square number or not. This, in this way, all the numbers, if we make the prime factorization, then we can only see whether this number is a square number or not.